Hey guys, today on Cooking with Carby, we're making breakfast. Everybody has their one favorite breakfast, and this is mine. It's a poached egg on top of some prosciutto, provolone, fresh greens, on top of a slice of nice crusty bread, topped with some fresh pesto. This is a supersized episode because we're making everything from scratch. That means we're learning to make bread, pesto, and how to poach eggs perfectly. Let's get started. If you don't already have a kitchen scale, it's definitely a kitchen gadget worth the 20 bucks. It's so much more accurate to measure your dry ingredients in grams rather than cups, as your volume might be different depending on the humidity on that given day. My bread recipe is adapted from Artisan Bread and Five's master recipe. It's going to make a lot of dough, but it's enough that you can keep it in the fridge and continue to make new loaves of bread for about 2 weeks, three or four loaves. We're starting with 900 grams, or about 6.5 cups of all-purpose flour, 1 tablespoon, or 9 grams of instant yeast, and 1.5 tablespoons, or 24 grams of kosher salt. Have you ever heard of that subreddit, Watch People Die Inside? Because if you could see my face, that's what's happening right now. I just now realized that when I set up my camera and I was trying to find a focus point, it wasn't working so well on a metal bowl, so I used a little container of fennel powder. And then I forgot to remove it, and I'm deciding, do I start over, or let's just keep going. After mixing the dry ingredients together, I'm creating a well in the middle before pouring in 3 cups or 750 milliliters of lukewarm water, and then just roughly mixing with a spatula to incorporate. We just don't want to have any dry patches of flour here, but this is a no-knead dough recipe, so we don't need to get our hands dirty, it doesn't need to look pretty or in a perfect ball, just roughly formed, and all equally incorporated. Cover with plastic wrap and poke a hole in the center of it, just a small one so some of the gas can escape, because this is definitely a gassy boy, and then throw a towel on top and let it sit at room temperature for 2 hours. After this 2 hour rise, it should have mostly flattened out on top, and it's ready to go. However, if you have the time and patience to take this and put it in the fridge for another 18 to 24 hours before making your first loaf, well, you're a stronger person than I am, and your bread is gonna taste even better. Sprinkle some flour on top of your dough and on top of some parchment paper, and then we're gonna pull out a little over 1 pound of dough. Somewhere between 500 and 600 grams is gonna make a nice medium-sized loaf of bread. The remaining amount gets covered with saran wrap and a towel again and put into the fridge. This dough is going to last in the fridge for up to 2 weeks. Flour your work surface and then we're going to form our dough into our loaf. I'm going for an oval oblong shape, but you can just go for a circle if you want. I'm doing this by grabbing from the bottom of my dough, pulling up towards the middle, and using my offhand to keep all of these collected parts together. Once I've gone in a full circle around my dough, smoothing out all these edges on the side, I'm pinching the seam together loosely, and then I'm going to flour the top of it lightly before flipping over and moving on to a sheet of parchment paper. The dough is still pretty delicate at this point, so we don't want to be pressing too hard or flattening it, so using a bench scraper to move onto the parchment paper is going to make life a little bit easier. Sprinkle the top of it with flour, cover it with a towel, and then let it rest for an hour. I'm going to bake my bread in a Dutch oven, as the lid lets me steam it for the first 15 minutes. If you don't have one, a cast iron pan or a pizza stone will work pretty well too. And now we can start on our pesto. We need about 4 cups of fresh basil, some olive oil, 1/2 cup of grated parmesan, 1/4 cup of pine nuts, a couple of cloves of garlic, and some salt. First step is toasting our pine nuts, spread evenly on a sheet pan and in an oven preheated to 350 degrees for 5 to 7 minutes, tossing halfway through just until they're golden brown. Once they're out of the oven, we can put our Dutch oven into the oven and continue to heat it up to 500 degrees. The rest of the pesto prep can be done in a blender, a food processor, by hand with a mortar and pestle. We're putting our garlic, our pine nuts, and our parmesan in first, pulsing a couple of times just to grate everything down to a consistent texture. Then we are going to add in all of our basil and a generous amount of olive oil. The olive oil is really going to depend on how much basil we had, and we're going to want to put a good glug in before we start mixing, and then continually add and press down the sides of our blender as we do this process. Depending on the amount of pesto you're making, this can be really easy or it can be really hard. The more you're making, the easier it is, as it's easier for the blender to emulsify everything. Don't be afraid to continue to add more olive oil as needed, or stop to scrape down the sides of your blender to make sure everything is getting evenly incorporated. In the end, I used about 3/4 of a cup of olive oil to get the texture that I wanted. Season to taste with some salt at the end, scrape down the sides, and use a funnel to pour into a squeeze bottle if you have one. Now that the dough has been resting for an hour, we're going to score it before we bake it. Using a serrated knife or a razor, we're dragging across in straight lines, about 1/4 inch deep. This is so that as it springs in the oven, it's in a controlled fashion. Into the Dutch oven that's been preheated, we're using our parchment paper to lift it in. Watch out, it's very hot. Bake first for 13 to 15 minutes with the lid on to trap all of the steam that is going to give our bread a nice oven spring, as well as a nicer colored crust, and then with the lid off for another 12 to 14 at 450 degrees. We're going for a deep golden brown color. If you tap on the crust, it should sound hollow inside. If you check the internal temperature, it should be about 195 to 205 degrees Fahrenheit. After it's cooled completely, we can slice our bread to toast and butter to get ready for the rest of our breakfast. This is also the perfect time to snack on the end of the bread because it's never going to be better than it is right now. For my poached eggs, I'm bringing 1 inch of water up to a simmer in a non-stick pan, cracking an egg into a wine glass and using the long stem to be able to gently place my egg into the water. I continue to place the other ones either in a clockwise or counterclockwise pattern so I know which egg went in first. After I have the eggs floating, I'm using a slotted spatula just to tuck underneath to make sure the egg is not sticking to the bottom of the pan. No fancy tricks here with vinegar or swirling, just maintaining a consistent temperature. Cook for about 2 minutes until the yolk is set to your liking, give it a jiggle to check to see how done it is, and then remove and drain any excess water from them. Then we can start plating. I started by buttering my toast, then some fresh garden lettuce, a couple of slices of provolone, a couple of slices of prosciutto, and then my poached egg. The last step is a drizzle of our basil pesto and a sprinkle of flaky salt. I had this breakfast for the first time about 10 years ago at a tiny little Italian cafe in Long Beach, California. They called it Wave Benedetto, and I've been trying to master it ever since. Something about the runny egg yolk, the fresh taste of the basil and the pesto, the salty prosciutto and provolone, and the crusty bread, it just all comes together so perfectly. There's obviously quite a lot of prep that goes into this meal. However, for a special occasion, it is definitely worth it. Outside of just this particular breakfast, you now have some new skills like baking bread, poaching eggs, and making fresh pesto, which have unlimited other uses. I hope you enjoyed the video and learned something. Please like and subscribe if you haven't already. Drop a comment if you have a suggestion for a future episode. See you in the next one.